Welcome, everybody. Thanks for coming into our Hadron Gospel Hour chat with Michael McQuilkin over there in Melrose, Hadron Bunker South. And I'm Rich Wentworth in Hadron Bunker North. And we're the creators of Hadron Gospel Hour. Our special announcement for this evening is something that we definitely wouldn't have dreamed about happening when we first started. So, Mike, you wanna give the announcement?
Oh, okay, sure. Yeah. We hit today. Was it today or yesterday?
It was yesterday, but it was April Fool's, so I didn't want to say it on April Fool's.
Because I know, right? It
would have no news is trustworthy on April Fool's.
Well, we hit 100,000 downloads. Now we're above 100,000 downloads.
But yes, 100K. 100K.
That's bananas. Bananas. But we have obviously all the fans to thank for that, and the word of mouth that's going on, and the way that this thing is growing exponentially is amazing. It's really just, it's my favorite thing that I'm involved with.
yeah. And thank you guys so much. This year's been great for us. It's our second year in this project. And, we've been to the Geeky Awards. We won Best Podcast at the Geeky Awards this year, which was just an unbelievable experience. We've won 2 Parsecs. But this is super special because this is all about you guys enjoying the show, telling your friends about it, and coming back, again. So honestly, we really can't thank you guys enough. This is a really cool moment for us because I think it's tough to do this work. We do it in the moments between moments. Mike and I both have day jobs and we have partners, and I have children, and Mike has a bunch of fur children, and we have to take care of them. And so this is really something that we make time for and make sacrifices for. So to have you guys show us in such a huge way how important that this show is to you, just honestly can't express how grateful we are for that.
It makes our day, makes our week, makes our month. I mean, the feedback has been amazing. Not just reviews, but the nice mentions, the downloads alone. I mean, daily, we're still getting tons of downloads a day, and I have to assume that's all new people or a result of the word of mouth campaign that the fans have worked so hard on. So it's just amazing. It's just been great, and we have no intention. This isn't by the way, we're getting divorced announcement.
Yeah,
I really want.
Well, yeah, we should actually make more episodes. We should actually make more episodes. I think that would be fun.
So we're just
going to
go ahead and make more episodes. in the
spirit of this, we've been thinking a lot about how to make this, how to transition into this being our full-time project, Mike and I have. And so we've wrestled with all the different ways to go about doing that, from advertising to Kickstarter. And, what we've decided to do is to launch a Patreon. So we are, as of right now, we have a Patreon. For those of you who don't know what a Patreon page is, Patreon is a platform where folks can pledge a certain amount, either per month or per episode, for content that they enjoy. It can be as low as $1 and as high as your imagination and wallet can expand to. But it's we've been looking into it for a while. It's a super, super cool platform. And so we've decided that's what we're gonna go with. So partly what we're doing right now is also inviting you guys to take a look at that page and to think if that's something that you would like to do. Of course, there's no hard feelings if you don't. And this show is always going to be free. We are never going to charge for this show. What we're trying to do is keep from having to do advertising, keep from having to do other methods of funding this show so that it can still be our voice, which you guys seem to appreciate. So I'll put the link in there right now. When you get a chance, take a look at it. Let's see. Can I do that? Hold on a second. While I'm doing that.
That secretly listen to Bunker. You know, it's funny that you mentioned that Icarus 7 rip. wouldn't that be a great coincidence? If like,
all right, let's see if this did that work. Is it up in there?
Yeah, do we have a?
There we go. So
we have an information leak in our inner circle.
Oh wait, I'm sorry. Hold on, albino pygmy monkey. Yeah. I think we will put a reward tier in there for folks who just want to aggressively hack the show and make their own plot lines for us to follow. But that will be, it will be a very expensive tier, I think. At least a dollar. At least a dollar.
Freedom does not come to you.
Right, right. Yeah.
Creative freedom.
And I think childcare will also be involved in that tier. You'll also have to take care of our children. We talk a little bit about the Patreon, because I just put the link up if you guys can see that. the basic pitch is that we want to keep making this show. We're just about two episodes shy of the end of this season. One is being worked on right now, and we can give a little update about that. And then the next one is in the writing phase, and we should be done with that towards the end of April, beginning of May. And then it's on to the third season. And we are, again, super excited to make the show. But we do need your help to continue to make it. And we would like to make more. We'd like to make them a more frequent thing. And right now we come out with episodes. If we're lucky, it's a month every 2 months. And we'd like to be able to do more of that. So
when we started, it was twice a month, and that still haven't.
Yeah. Yeah. I was neglecting my family quite a bit.
Right.
And
that probably can't happen until one of us or both of us is not working.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I think that's the eventual goal. And I mean, most creators, I imagine it's the eventual goal for, I think we've got something that we're working on here that we're doing that, people are letting us know is valuable to them and that they enjoy it. So we're going to keep making it. We'd like to make more. We'd like to make them more frequent. We have a bunch of other plans that we'd like to talk to you about tonight as well. Some pretty cool stuff that we've been working with other partners on, as well as some ideas that we have for shows that would grow out of Hadron. That's actually probably a good way to seg into the InvestiKids. Mike, you want to talk a little bit about the InvestiKids?
So the InvestiKids was, we did a pilot for an animated idea a few years ago called the InvestiKids. And they're like six or seven at the beginning characters who were sort
at
of
least.
Like
this, in this.
Yeah. It's kind of a throwback to the old Encyclopedia Brown and the kid, you know, detective stories and all that. But, you know, it's got a very distinctive, absurd tinge to it. But we really liked the pilot. It came out really well. The animators fell through, so that kind of got pushed to the wayside. The InvestiKids appeared in an episode this season, the Abductees versus Contactees episode.
Yeah, episode 17. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 17. So we'd like
they managed to trap Higsby.
Right.
Which is, I mean, so they're clever. A bunch of kids. Right.
And that kind of cleverness deserves its own podcast. So we would like to create an InvestiKids show as well. That'll be more split up. We think we're going to do that, in 15-minute chunks, three-act chunks, something like that? Or 5-minute chunks?
Yeah, that would be, I believe, 10 to 15-minute chunks.
right.
Three of those for a story arc. I mean, a mini story arc, and then an overarching story arc as well. So, and we've got the first one this is something we did again. We did as a animation pilot, and so we have the first two episode scripts are done in that form, and we just need to sort of repurpose them so that we can break them up into three piece chunks, and then we will be able to. That yeah, I mean, so we have the first six episodes of that are at least fairly written.
Mm-hmm. And we're looking forward to seeing those too. But the time to make them.
That's what it is. Know, yeah.
But
it is something that's something we want to do, and it's in the cards. Mm-hmm. So, there's a couple of requests to say, okay, so, you want to help me out? I don't know. It might not work with any kind of time delay, but we'll give it a shot.
Is there a delay in my voice?
No, I don't think so. All right. Ready?
Okay.
I can already tell that the delay is going
to
be
right to the chicken.
Very strange.
Right to the chicken.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not anyway. Going to work.
But I did put a link up to the actual theme. If you guys want to check it out.
So as soon as we hit $200, we'll come up with a better version of that theme.
So that's the thing. So that's our actual, we've made that our first goal on the Patreon page. When we get $200 total, dollars in pledges, per episode or whatnot, of HGH, we'll throw the Investi Kids at you. So that's a pretty low hanging fruit, I think. The next one up we have is for a soundtrack album, a digitally downloadable soundtrack album that would feature all the music from Hadron. So the theme, all of the different pseudo bands that we put together to play in the episodes. So you get and we would do it. We want to professionally mixed and mastered. So you'd have just
the full versions of the songs,
that you hear glimpses of in the show. So you know you can
also
do it.
Like to do a record. All the kids. Are
well,
doing
yeah. So that's the thing. So then the next tier up from that would be an LP. But we'll make it available as a digital download first. And yeah, that's kind of an exciting thing. Let's think what else we got here to tell folks about. For those of you arriving late, the big announcement is that we just passed 100K total downloads. So, we were expecting cake, a lot of folks expecting cake. But the cake is not truthful. There is no truth to that cake.
Truth. The cake is a lie.
The cake is, that's what I meant to say.
Oh, that was on the nose, right? No, I like the way you're dancing around it better.
It's okay.
That's too on the nose.
It's all right. It's all right.
I blew it. Rich, we talked about it.
We're going to get through this. I put the link up again for the Patreon over there. I'll put it in the thing too over here. So I hope everybody's enjoying this. I sure am. You guys enjoying this?
You guys know this is running until Sunday, right?
Now, so here's another thing that's really pretty cool. And This is a project that we've been thinking about for a little while, and will this work? Let's see. We've been talking with our friends. My screen's flashing. Really? Oh yeah. Is that better? Weird.
Oh, Rich, solar flares. Get the hell out of there.
Yeah.
Get out of there.
So here's a project that we are going to do. And this is something that's, regardless, this is a whole separate thing. This is a partnership that we are engaged in with AfterBuzz TV, who is, the top, after show network, in the world, really. They just passed a billion downloads for the year. Recently. And so they're just doing crazy, crazy great. But what they do is they do after shows, for TV shows. So, you know, Jersey Shore, you just watched it. You want to, you know, catch up on, just talk about it. So it's sort of like what they do with The Talking Dead, but they were doing it earlier than that. And we've been talking with them. We're going to do a program that is devoted to Saturday morning cartoons, and it's going to be called the Saturday Morning Adventurecade. And it's basically all of the junk that Mike and I watched as little kids, and we'll be breaking down a particular series every episode. And we intend to have folks from those series when we can to interview, and special guests that we know who are also pop culture junkies and sugary cereal addicts as well as we are. So I just put up
a lot of the culture of Saturday morning is going to be covered too, you know, from that time. It's a huge nostalgia implosion for us.
Right. So we'll be able to feel the beanbag chairs. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Tactile, scratch and sniff, all that. But yeah, that should be fun.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of stuff to cover.
Yeah. Yeah.
A lot of cartoons.
So that is something that will be premiering in May. Stay tuned for that, and go ahead and like the Facebook page if you are interested in hearing more about that. Paul Gannon says he wants in on that, and I want Paul Gannon in on that too. I definitely want to talk with some folks from the UK about this sort of the specifics of what the Saturday morning experience was like over there. And I want to know how many people of our age group know about Mooncat, because I've only been able to find a little bit about Mooncat, but he looks amazing. And so if anybody can tell us about that when we get into this, that'll be great. So that'll probably be a twice a month situation, the Saturday Morning Adventurecade. And we're already working on the first couple of episodes of that. With potentially exciting guests, I imagine. So anyway, stay tuned for that. And again, also take a look at AfterBuzz TV in general, because they do really good work with a bunch of TV shows. So I know that they have, you know, a lot of our crew here are into science fiction. They have a few science fiction shows that they follow. They are very cool folks. We like them a lot. I want to mention another thing while we're just blabbing away here, and that is, if you haven't yet, you can follow, you can subscribe to our actual email newsletter. If you use email, some people still do. It's a good way to keep up with what we're doing. And let's see. So I think,
and there's fun games and stuff in it too.
Yeah, I do crossword. Yeah, we make crossword puzzles and word searches. So what the heck? I don't know why anybody wouldn't want to.
It's free.
Yeah, it's free. All right. I think that covers all the news. Did we get all the news, Mike, about what's going on? And I see we have a question. And if you guys have questions for us about Hadron in general, start asking them in the chat bar, or you can queue up to come on here. I'd like to get Paul on in a few. So, Paul, if you want to get yourself queued up for that. Before we answer the questions, though, why don't we just give folks an update on where the new episode is at right now? So we've had all the people come in and record. Paul Gannon is one of them, and we'll talk to him about that in a little bit. We had Kareem Cronfy came in, also from the UK, and who else did we have? Mark Gallagher.
Local
comedian Mark Gallagher, Phoebe Angle, also local comedian and very funny, from the Boston area here. Our usual cast of characters, our usual folk. Vera Shrankung, who has been on the show numerous times and has played numerous characters, is fantastic. The lovely Wendy McLean is on this episode. Who's been on the show again a lot of times. And so right now it's in the editing phase. We have all the recording done, and now we're in the editing phase. Right?
Yes.
That's pretty much it.
We can bundle in that question there, Stu. It looks like
let's get Stu's
question. Everybody separate.
Yep.
So we record everyone separate for the most part. Yeah, I don't think we've done any dual. At the beginning, Rich and I would be in the same room. We'd go back and forth, but the tracks are all separate, and then we link them up in the editing process to make it more conversational and organic and work on the flow. And we direct the people as they're recording. So,
yeah, one of us or the other is always present to direct. Right. So we have the episode in our heads and can kind of direct folks to where we need them to be. In some cases, though, we have folks do remote work, and generally we'll give them an idea of what we want, and if they have questions, they'll let us know, and that's been working fairly well.
Yeah, they get a free copy of the HGH way, which is the way we do things. It's also a lot of like 700 pages. But you know, once they get to the end of it, they fill out a little questionnaire, and then we allow them to be on the show. And typically, they do a really good job, and people don't complain about it. So, I think it's a good method.
I just realized that I could press Stu's question and have it come up on the thing which is very cool. Right, so, there. Yeah. Here's another thing, which is that you know, kind of in conjunction with our sort of you know, Patreon push here, we will be doing these updates on a frequent basis. We'll be doing these blabs on a frequent basis. I'm thinking we'll do it every few weeks, you know, a little bit more frequently than monthly probably, but not every week, because then, you know, I think we'd all get sick of each other, and we don't want to do that. We want to have fun in here. So, yeah, we'll be doing these on a fairly regular basis. These will be available to anyone, not just patrons, but there are a bunch of pretty cool rewards for our patrons. So I won't go into all of them right now, but you can take a look over at the page. One of them is a custom recorded message from an HGH cast member, though, which is pretty cool, right?
Are we gonna? Do they get to choose?
I don't think so. No, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, we'll see. I mean, I think we should do it randomly. Yeah, we should do a 20-sided die and roll it and see what comes up.
Right. Because people love all the characters, right?
And like people love 20-sided dice.
And D&D references. Mm-hmm. Who does?
Yep.
Yeah. So, nice little bennies. Mm-hmm.
Are there any other questions before we bring? Sorry. Is the wipe sound effect? Yes. Okay. Mm. Let's look at Kevin Hartnell, our friend Kevin's question. Brilliant okay. Musician, and all around Renaissance man. Welcome, Kevin. So, is the wipe sound effect used in HGH inspired by the classic Hanna-Barbera sound effects? Yes. Not of course, but yes, of course. I was listening to the Super Friends transition sound, and I tried to emulate that as closely as I could, and that's what came out. So, yes, good question. Thanks. Totally.
And the visual, totally Hanna-Barbera. You know, we would have a big logo come towards the screen and then pull back. If this were an,
yeah, and show. That's another thing. So
I bet you people are imagining that though when they're listening to it in their own heads.
Yeah, yeah, and those stars with the 70s lens.
Yeah, they form one, then they break up again.
Yeah, that actually is a good that is a good reminder that one of the things that we want to accomplish. In the next year or two is we would like to develop a live action Hadron web series. And we have some good folks that want to work on that with us. And it's just a question of getting the time. And so for us, that time is money as well. So that will be at some point, we will fold that into the goals on the Patreon page. So if we keep ramping up, that's one of the things that we'll unlock at that point. And I'm really looking forward to it because, you know, to be honest with you, I don't get to wear that makeup as much as I'd like to. And my face has not been dried out. So I'm missing that experience of feeling that like terrible dried out feeling.
You know, I'd wear it if
sure. If it made any sense. Yeah. To no, I know.
You don't have to take all of this burden.
You go, makeup. Right. You go the extra mild, though, because you dress exactly like your character on the show. Like when you're in character, it's you're totally Mike.
Well, layers. I mean, it might be hot outside, but I'll have layers on. I'll have the jacket and a classic gaming console T-shirt.
Yeah, things you would never wear.
Get stuffy
in real life. I am
my family somebody. Doesn't recognize me when I'm dressed as Mike Wilkinson.
Right. No, it's me, Mike.
It's me. Please let me attend dinner with you for Easter or Christmas or whatever.
I had a thought.
And, I'm your son, brother.
Oh, wait, hold on. Let's have some cake.
Is there some sort of button?
I think so. There we go. Let's have some 100K cake. Do you see the cake, Mike? Does it look delicious?
It looks good. Sure. I think it's designed that way. Right. Wow.
I was just told
consume cake now.
This just in, I was just told that, that Henry wants to say hi. So he's going to come in and say hi. All right.
Hey, Henry.
Hey, nice shirt.
Love that shirt.
Congratulations. All right.
He said congratulations. Thank you. All right. I love you. All right. There he is.
Bye.
Bye, Henry.
He was expressly forbidden to come in here, and he's going to get an earful later. Oh. No, I'm kidding.
Wow.
That's my son, Henry.
Dark turn.
It's my son, Henry. all right. So I just want to talk a little bit about we're good. I was going to say we'd talk about the goals, but we've really talked about a lot of what we want to do. Oh, we didn't mention the tour. Listener's mate Anthony has a question here. Oops.
Hi, Tony.
What happened here?
It's over on the right, too. Was the opening to HGH inspired by the Croft Superstar Hour and other variety shows in the 1970s? I can hear that, some of that in there, sure.
The Croft, the Brothers Croft output, kind of infuses everything that we do, for sure.
They're in both of our DNA.
Yeah, I think that when you're listening to our show, you should be hearing the chroma key, the badly done chroma key, where everybody's outline is all blue and there's puppetry.
Sometimes the hair pieces of the hair will disappear.
Yeah, no, it's great. Yeah. Or if you have like a mirror, and everybody always had mirrored clothing that would get the back, you'd see the background through it. Specifically though, the opening was sort of a mashup of sort of the $6 Million Man and the Incredible Hulk. Kevin's got it. Yeah. $6 Million Man and the Incredible Hulk, pretty much. And the reason was that we wanted something that would hold a narration, and they had just absolutely figured that out in the 70s. So that part is that first part, the preamble is like that, and then the Hadra loose. Stu. We're here, we're there. We're everywhere. The rift actually makes that possible. Whereas with the Bugaloos, it was an idle threat. With the Hadron crew, they actually can follow up on that. Good point. But the second,
not enough wings in Hadron.
No, but there will be. We can do that. We can absolutely do that. If people want wings, we can accommodate that. If there's like an insect version of furries that we can appeal to, I might be that. I might be that. But the second half of the theme is sort of more of an homage musically to the Super Friends or Battle of the Planets kind of upbeat, slightly orchestral kind of thing. And speaking of 70s, kind of upbeat intro themes, the Saturday Morning Adventurecade, we're working on that right now, and that theme is going to have a lot of amplitude to it, 70s amplitude. So thanks for the question, Anthony. Let's see. Paul, come on in. Where are you? We're going to get Paul in here now. And Paul Gannon is...
Paul's shuddering.
Oh, there we go.
He's shuddering.
Come on in, Paul. I'm accepting you. So while Paul's connecting here, Paul Gannon is a comedian and a podcaster. Hey, Paul.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, can.
Oh, good. Yeah. Just so you know, it is 1:30 a.m. here.
Hey!
Like bollocks.
Much appreciated.
In advance.
Well, we're excited that you're up past your bed.
Well, you're clearly out of sorts. Your mic logo is upside down.
No,
we appreciate your
presence. That's a good point. It's because basically it's meant to be like this.
Right, like I'm doing.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
The professional way, like I'm Yeah. Anyway.
Oh, I didn't know where this was going to be a call out moment.
So Paul, just so everybody knows, Paul, you're a comedian, you're a podcaster, you're a performer in a variety of different things, and not the least of which was you've been on an episode of Hadron already.
Yeah.
In the Starnesty episode.
Yeah,
you played Paul.
Space cop.
Hmm. Yeah, member of the transdimensional trig. Mm-hmm. And actually, Paul is in the current episode as well. So you would normally be awake now, though, right? This is. Oh, we lost. Hold on.
Your mic's out.
Wait, we lost you. Your mic is out. Oh, what is he doing to the mic? No, we can't. No. Oh, good.
The desperate look in the face is
nope. It's not happening.
No.
Oh my goodness! What happened to Paul? I can't hear anything. Mm-mm. Oh boy.
Oh, something just clicked.
Mike, can we get someone in there to?
Let me call a tech in the UK.
Yeah. It's not working. So no. Hi. Yeah, we'll wait. We'll wait. Yep. Okay. So Paul will come back.
I thought he was going to do shit. One word. Okay.
Well, we should talk to the cake for a little while.
Let's pretend the cake is Paul. So Paul, interesting choice of frosting.
Yeah. What the flowers? Hold on.
We got to call Paul.
Sorry. Real Paul is coming in. Not cake Paul.
Cake Paul.
Let's try
no,
this.
No, nothing.
Oh my gosh, Paul. It was fine. What happened? Unplugged. Oh boy.
While you were gone, we anthropomorphized to speak to cake.
Try again. You know what? You should probably try jump out and then come back in. Like out of the whole thing. Yes. Okay. We've got it.
Two words.
All right. So
one word first word. Right. Ear and ear. Oh, sounds like.
Ear? Sounds like. Sounds yeah. See, we're both
walking.
Crap.
Oh, so wait a minute. We're getting somewhere.
Ernest Borgnine. What?
No.
No. Okay.
Cake.
All right. cake.
Oh, boy. I'm so sorry about the coughing.
Yeah, I think the browser is, Anthony's got the right idea with the browser refresh. Mm-hmm. So, but that was humorous, and I hope other people found that as humorous as we did.
What you may not know is that entire sequence was planned. Went off without a hitch.
Absolutely. Mm, yeah.
Sillies. Belated April Fool's Day. That's right.
Right. Yeah. Perhaps. Yeah. I wouldn't put it past
Paul. We would have done it yesterday, but
he's a trickster.
We're busy. And plus, everybody else is doing it on the first, you know? You can't be a trendsetter by doing what everybody else does on the April 1st.
Right. That's right. You have mm-hmm. to do it at your own pace. Here we go. What's going on here? No. Okay.
I was really looking forward.
Well, I know this is a bit sad. So if anybody has any other questions, feel free to jump in. If you want to get in line or in queue, I guess to jump in and have us not be able to hear you, then you may do that as well. Oh, here we go.
Calling.
Let's Yeah, let's talk to Anthony while we're waiting for Paul to come back.
Hey guys, what's up?
I'm scripting. Hey, what's going on?
Hey, Anthony.
I could do that right now. And
Wait a minute. Hold on a second.
I'm joking. The Hadron messed up, so no.
But,
hey, how y'all doing, guys?
Good.
How are you doing? I know Rich knows me a little bit. You know me through Facebook. I'm the guy who runs Wentworth. Yesterday. Briefly. Just kind of want to hop in, just let you know that I'm here. I support you. I've listened to half of the 18 episodes. So I've listened to 9 so far. I binge watched them all last night.
Thank you. Just to let you know that
I did see you on the Geeky Awards. I'm very good friends with Kristen Metapack through the web series community.
We love Kristen.
She's a lovely, hot babe.
Super hard work. Yeah, wonderful. Puts a lot of work.
She has a lot of integrity and a lot of sincerity also. Mm-hmm. I've interviewed her on a segment I do on my YouTube channel called my YouTube channel is Lister's Mate 2. And I do.
I do a segment called semi-impromptu interviews
with my YouTube friends. And so she's been in one of the interviews that I do. And I also saw you at the International Academy Web Television Awards. I'm good friends with those people. Jeff Burns was one of the seat members at the time, but,
We like Jeff. We got to meet Jeff at the ITV but, Fest.
Yeah, I'm good gorgeous. With him. Yeah. He's part of the reason that I made web series friends because all the people at Super Geeked Up or Super Knocked Up got me involved in the web series community. I saw a lot of zeal and valor and everything else. And I cannot type and talk at the same time here. So, okay.
Don't worry about it. But I totally appreciate you spreading the word about this chat. I noticed you shared the link far and wide. It gave me a bunch
over there
of
in the chat.
Oh, there it is. Great. Thank you.
Right there. There's also a link to my other YouTube channel, which is for my family's business, which is totally nothing to do with web series or sci-fi or whatever. You know,
no quantum weaponry. Well, they don't do quantum weaponry.
Quantum weaponry, yes.
Oh, really? Yes. Oh, that's great. Yeah.
Yeah.
Old time country music is good country, stuff.
Yes. Yeah. We have with my family, we have a coffee shop and a tea room, and it's in Galax, Virginia. It's in Galax, Virginia.
Where is it?
Where the bluegrass music got started, and also where the International Fillers Convention is every year. And not only am I into science fiction and web series and podcasts, I'm also into country music, bluegrass, that kind of thing. So yes, I'm a very eccentric fellow.
That's great.
Fellow. But
yeah, well, I think a lot of us are that end up in this, you know, weird spot. But do you have a stage at that?
Yeah, there's two of them. There's a big stage where a lot of the people come in and play old time country music for probably about 2 or 3 hours at a time. I record a lot of them because I don't have to worry about copyright issues because they play mostly free public domain stuff. And then there's
super old stuff.
Another little stage where people come and they play anything from old time country to classic country, current country, blues, bluegrass, whatever they want to play, you know, pretty much. And so,
that's great.
You know, I get a lot of video from people playing cards at the shop and people coming in and out and different things. But so if you want,
do you think that folks would be cool with a science fiction audio comedy coming in, doing a live show sometime?
I would have to talk to
my mother. Would that be a little too out of there? Please do. Yeah. Yeah. Let him know we're good folks. We'd be nice.
But if you want to see my other channel, there it is. Dreaming Coffee.
Well, dude, thank you.
It's right there. On. But I just want to hop in and just let you know, I do promote you on Web Series Friends. I initially started Web Series Friends just for web series only. And then I realized, hey, there's a lot of good content on there. They're not just web series, they're podcasts too. And they're in a way like a series because it's a serial thing.
And yeah, so, for sure. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it meets the definition. Yeah. It's just not video, but yeah, yeah, absolutely. And I really thank you for, you know, finding us and, yeah,
And so now, Blab is a web series in itself, and there are great shows here on Blab.
Yeah.
And,
so, very cool. Yeah. Yeah. We're just starting to learn about it. So any tips you have about, stuff we should be looking at, shows that are on that you find interesting or that we might find interesting, just kick us links.
If you want to join my group, if you have a podcast and you want to join my group, or you have a web series, please feel free to join. It is a closed group, so I or some or another one of the moderators will let you in. Please go to that link right there, and that will take you to Web Series Friends. And it's been up since March of last year and now has 1,336 members.
Hey. So, pretty cool. Yeah. That's great. Fantastic. It's a very rapidly growing field. And we've noticed that with audio drama in the audio field. There's been an explosion the past couple of years. So we got on into doing this, in the end of 2013 and, there was some life happening. It was already kind of in swing, but it seems like just this past year, there's been it's just been exponential. Yeah. the amount of folks working on stuff like this. And I imagine it's the same way with web series as well. Just because the technology is there, and people are looking for ways to kind of easily get their stories out
that way.
A lot
of people like Jeff Burns. I have to plug Jeff Burns. Jeff Burns, who runs.
Oh my God! Yeah, he's amazing. Let's plug Jeff Burns.
Every Wednesday night on YouTube at 10 o'clock. Matter of fact, I run a Blab now, where I stream Super Geeked Up every Wednesday via the Dropbox. Mm-hmm. So, if you want to,
I want to talk to you offline a little bit more about that process because that sounds interesting to me. So if we could chat about that, that would be great. The Dropbox Blab connection.
It's really a neat feature. Anybody who's a co-host or a host can pretty much use a drop feature. So.
I like
just
it.
Fight over it.
Well, thanks for popping in, Anthony. I appreciate it.
I wanted to know the story behind the guy in the wall.
Oh, okay. So
Cyrus.
Cyrus. So Cyrus, Cyrus is someone who worked at the lab, who was a maintenance person at the lab, and during the Hadron event was out in the hallway and became fused with the wall when sort of the fabric of reality kind of rippled out from the Hadron blast and
the Philadelphia experiment and the ship.
Yes. Yeah, and the
generation what did that too with the girl halfway. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to, actually hold on 1 second here.
But were they as wackily lovable as Cyrus?
No,
no way. So,
and Michael Atkinson plays Cyrus, and he's really run with that character.
Yeah. I like that character.
He really did. Yeah. Let's see if I can,
a clip,
but, yeah,
well, no, not a clip. So I just wanted to bring the, a link in, but there was a specific, inspiration for that thing, having someone sticking out of a wall, fused to a wall. And it was Brian Lumley's book, Necroscope, his Necroscope series. Brian Lumley was a science fiction author. Yeah. One of the features in that book is an incident that happens in Russia where a dimensional gateway is created, which is to this vampire world. But in the accident, you know, people are fused with inanimate objects and stuff, but they all die or are like screaming in pain. And I just thought it would be very funny to have that happen. But the guy's like totally positive and upbeat and just hanging there. And actually Cyrus is playing a big part in the upcoming cool. episode. So
well, I still got a lot of ways to go. That'll be a new lot of fun. Episode. Yeah. I'm still like episode 10. So yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You get some ground to cover. That's good. Some people here in this group, I imagine, who are in this chat tonight have finished all the episodes and are
I binge watch and binge listen to everything. So yeah, I don't mind.
That's good. Yeah. We've heard from a lot of people that they've done that. And I totally, that's the way I consume a lot of stuff as well. So even stuff that's live now that I could watch from week to week. Before, I sometimes save them up a little
I listen
bit.
To you. I knew about you because I knew about you to the web series community. I saw you, get your awards and I'm like, I started liking you and just following some of your posts and like, I'll get around to them eventually. I don't know.
Yeah, well, that's fine. Yeah.
So eventually he's finally shown up.
Well, I appreciate it. We appreciate every listener we can get, and especially folks who, spread the word.
Another good thing you might want to try, since Jeff really well, ask him to be on Super Geeked Up one Wednesday. Yeah.
Yeah, we've actually got we've had a standing invitation. Mike, were you on that show yet?
No.
Mike, were you on there? No. Okay. I think we've had some schedule stuff. So, but we'll definitely be on there when the stars align.
Also, has anyone put you on StumblePon yet?
I don't know
that.
I still use StumblePon.
That's still around?
Yes, I use it daily.
That's a good idea.
Matter of fact, after I hang up with you, I'll pull up another tab, pull up your website, and I'll like it, and it'll be on a database. And
that's great.
Thanks, man.
People will eventually find you some way. But yeah.
So. Yeah, we can use all the help we can get to get in front of as many people as possible, and I guess that's the. That's the
even if stumbling's involved.
21st century.
There's no shame.
Right.
No
right.
Shame in stumbling. Let's get right back on.
Now I wonder, is Paul not coming
back up? Paul wants to hop back in. I can hop back off. So
I don't know. I think, let's see if he can jump in.
So, guys, it was good talking to you.
All right. Thanks so much, Anthony. Bruce, thank you for coming.
Talk to me more on Facebook. Michael, connect with me through Rich, please. And
yeah, we'll do. Yeah. I just like the Facebook community there too.
So thank you. Thank you.
If you're so kind, please allow me to join.
Thank you, Anthony.
But thank
appreciate
you,
man.
It. And
War Duke appreciates
Paul, you.
Oh, you
look like Simon Pegg, by the way. So.
Totally. Well,
the thing, funny story. We thought he was Simon Pegg, and we were really excited about having him here. And then it turns out it was Paul Gannon.
But Paul was available.
But he's good too.
I wonder if he's going to try to come back on.
Let's see. Calling in.
All right. This is fun. I'm having fun.
Yay!
All right, Paul, let's keep our fingers crossed. You got it. Hey! I can,
Although I'm telling you, I was committed to the charades.
Oh.
And I'm trying to decide if this is better or worse.
Let's see how it goes. And if I'm not, kidding. I'll pull the mic out.
Sure. That works usually.
So how are you guys doing?
Go on. So we're doing great. We're doing great. We're getting loose now.
It's all this digital cake.
Fairly loose. Yeah, we're eating some digital cake. I'm super happy that we've all got our mugs. Can we all drink a little bit here to 100K?
Cheers.
Mine's orange.
Cheers.
Hot toddies.
Oh, that's it.
And of course, Paul's mug is a Ghostbuster mug.
I got these from a friend.
Because Paul is the number one, should know about this. Paul is the number one Ghostbusters fan
possibly.
In the UK.
It's self-titled, if anything. That's true.
Oh, I didn't.
Yeah, so, self-proclaimed.
I thought the Royals were involved.
Yeah, we don't talk about the Royals. They're basically our Disneyland.
TV series.
A fan who listens to my podcast sent a set of four mugs. Got a
Ghostbuster
on. So Winston, Ray, Egon, Peter. So that was pretty cool.
Yeah,
it is cool.
Yeah. And also, I don't have cake, but I do have chocolates. Unfortunately, because it's long wait, they are all now gone.
Bullet? What was your favorite out of there?
Actually, the vanilla cup and the praline heart are quite nice. And the crunchy frog is good also. Oh,
right. Crunchy frog.
That
yeah.
Sounds like that's a insider candy.
There's one that has a maple nougat in it that's my favorite one. Oh, yeah. I don't know if maple, do you guys get maple syrup over there?
No, we barely get technology at all.
Apparently.
We have no idea what sugar is. I've heard rumors of potatoes, but I...
Oh, they're good. We will bring some in May.
Now, here's the weird thing. When I lived in LA for a few months, way back when, I had this dinner party with this guy who goes, oh, where are you from? Oh, the UK. Okay. And he goes, do you still have potatoes out there? Thinking it was A, Ireland, and B, the 1600s.
Yeah. So, and that guy's ahead of the curve a little bit in terms of intelligence for us Americans.
It's not like that at all.
Yeah, whatever, Paul.
Yeah.
No. So this forthcoming episode will be your second episode.
Yeah.
Of Hadron. Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy recording?
I always enjoy hanging out. I've always been reasonable. I feel blessed that you invited me in, because I know I came through this via Kevin, basically, didn't I?
Kevin Harrington, voice of Higsby,
because
all around general brand ambassador for Hadron.
Yeah, that's the guy. Because we came over, me and a guy called Richard Sandlin came over and did the Boston Comic Con Geek Week.
Yeah.
Although we did do Boston Comic Con as well, actually. We did Matt Kona's podcast while we were out there. But funnily enough, you mentioned the Simon Pegg thing. Me and Sandlin, when you put us together, do look like the knockoff Bargain Hunt version of Simon Pegg and Nick Frost.
If we morphed you into... Ah, I like that, yeah.
If you face swapped me and him.
Yeah.
It's
terrifying.
And the funny thing is that I was also in Shaun of the Dead. So there are pictures.
That's right.
That's great.
Simon Pegg together.
Yeah.
We're twins. He returns my calls all the time.
I'm glad.
Right to twin. We don't need technology. Twins.
Yeah. That's how they do all the stunt double stuff was all me, obviously.
Sure.
Now I think that so my partner Wendy, who is coming with us to London, as well as Mike's wife Lisa, now they're probably excited about what you might have in store for us about, like, for Nights on the Town. What can you reassure Wendy who's listening that we're going to be doing some really fun stuff?
Yeah, I've got us tickets to a couple of strip shows in Soho.
Oh,
and
like excellent
shows.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Soho is really so. That's kind of a national treasure. Mm. So it's like we're going to see some culture.
Yeah, so it's burlesque, right?
When we go there,
Soho's got some really nice burlesque shows, and I got a load of good friends who are there. But actually,
just street stripping.
We can do when we're out there. Some really nice little restaurants and bars we can go to, and also the Comic Con's on in May in London at the end of that weekend that you're there.
That's right.
I'm in talks at the moment for a few events on there. One of them is a Ghostbusters Q&A, of course, and the other one is we're going to do Cheap Show Live. And if that happens, I want you guys to be guests on it.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah,
so you will have to.
Wendy will signal by doing the little hand clap thing. If she thinks that's a good idea, let's just wait. Oh, yes. Yay.
Yeah,
give Mike a couple. Give Mike a couple, Wendy.
Oh, okay.
Good. Give Mike a couple. There you go.
Yeah. Wendy will keep it clean. Seriously. No drinking.
Yeah.
The two hands up. See, I thought that was a stop.
No, I think the drinking is probably okay. The drinking is
acceptable. I thought that was an indication to stop talking. That's what the two hands. That's what I thought that was. And I have 451 of them, so I should have shut up 450 times.
It's all this thing.
Right.
So, Paul,
yeah,
tell us about some of the stuff you're working on right now, because I think some of our fans would be. First off, we should say that Mike and I have actually already been on Cheap Show a couple of times.
Yeah, you have. I don't know if it's strictly canon, but you have appeared as your characters in Cheap Show in our Halloween episodes.
Well, it's canon for our show. I thought it was mutual, but okay.
Yeah. Well, that's
it's somewhat canonical.
Yeah, if it's canon for you, it's canon for us. We basically have two Halloween episodes where you guys kind of beam in and affect the show slightly, then beam out and leave a whole load of havoc in your wake. So that was cool. And that was, again,
those really are very fun to do.
Yeah. And it's nice to have that kind of back and forth. It's kind of nice to have that community. So,
yeah,
it was nice to have you guys on Cheap Show, because that's my little pet project that I really love. And obviously the guy, Eli Silverman, I could present it with. He's the grottiest little man in the universe, but apparently, but apparently the universe love him. So it's funny as well.
Well, now so that's how you lead off every show. Yeah. Is with some nice comments about each other, and I always enjoy what you guys
we have about. A mutual disrespect for each other.
It's healthy.
It needs to be reestablished.
And Eli's fantastic as well in the Starnesty episode. And
yeah.
I'm looking forward to having him back on again as well.
Yeah,
he was so and I don't want him to. I want him to take us. Oh, about not
but
being
not
on this
it,
one.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, geez.
No, but it was all in good sport, because I lied to him and said there was going to be an episode just about him in your third series.
Oh, very good.
So you probably like that.
That's fine.
Or I'm in trouble.
Right.
I will totally do that. Well,
we'll do another road trip with just Eli.
Yeah. That's fine.
He was very helpful to you in your recording session. I could hear in what you guys recorded.
Yeah, because we back record our episodes. We do two a month. So we have a time in the radio studio that I produce in, and we did it all in one go, and it was really cool. And yeah, fun. It was so much fun. I'm really looking forward to hearing it all finished and tidied up and all lovely.
Do you want to put a link in the chat bar Cheap Show so that people can check it out?
Should hawk my wares. So,
well, you know.
But this is the thing. It's like you say, what am I up to? And it's like, well, get comfortable. Here's 1,000 things I'm currently
right.
not doing.
Right. Well, what am I not up to? Right. That's the.
Yeah.
There you go. So everybody in the chat bar, take a look. Paul just put up a link to his podcast, which is very funny and very excellent.
It's
you should all check it out.
It's a kind of discussion show about the celebrating cheap things around the world. Bargain and charity shops and 99p stores and things like that. But we have some recorded episodes, some live episodes, some episodes that have done reports from festivals, and some that are completely fictional plays. So it's a weird mix of whatever we feel like doing that month. Again, I'm a fond of it. So I will do that. I also do a podcast called The Spooktator, which is a ghost hunting podcast, because obviously I go ghost hunting, even though I don't believe in ghosts. We'll move on.
I think that's the best way to do it.
I'm doing a ghost hunt in the most haunted house in the UK, where there's a poltergeist and a mad monk, apparently. So that's what I'm doing there.
Ooh.
How many psychics are going with you?
No, we no psychic
Wait
policy.
A minute.
We
come on now.
Go for that kind of stuff.
Ah, but that's the fun, though. No. When they,
I turn it off. If I see a psychic, I'm.
Derek Acora is the reason to watch. Most Haunted, right?
And I've worked with Derek Acora as well, professionally.
Oh, boy.
Oh, I've got so many stories legally I can't
tell you. Oh, really?
So, yeah.
Offline? No,
because just for instance, I tell you this story now and it gets out, I will get a nasty email from his people. Oh. And it's happened already for my solo show. So, yeah, anyway.
Well, let me go on record for saying that he too, much like the strip clubs of Soho, is a national treasure.
He really is.
So, so hopefully that will set him at ease. It will assuage his rage, his anger.
If anyone wants to know more about Derek Acora, just simply look up Derek Acora, Mary Loves Dick in YouTube.
Oh, yes.
It's a gift that keeps on giving.
Writing that down.
Because I worked with quite a lot of psychics when I was researching my solo show about ghost hunting. And there's this one psychic in the UK called Colin Fry. And when he was alive, he said when he dies, he's going to have this secret word. And he's going to tell the world in his passing what this secret word was. And then, sadly, actually, last year he did die. This was unexpected to him and his family. So I went onto his fan page and I said, I wonder what his secret word will be. And one of his fans came back to me and said, how dare you exploit the dead for your entertainment? And I had to go... Think about what you just said.
Right. Like John Edwards, right?
Yeah. So yeah, I'm very busy. I've got podcasts
now,
and a YouTube channel as well that I produce, and Eli's in that as a dirty stormtrooper. So
is there any
wait, what is that? What is this?
I produce a podcast a channel on YouTube called Bartians. It's these two guys who
Right.
And we do this thing called Poor Man's Cosplay, where we tell you how to make a very, very cheap stormtrooper costume for about £5. involving white bin bags and a white bucket.
Oh,
we put a link for that too, please.
Oh, I'll have a look
when you get a chance. Yeah. But I just wanted to quickly say too, your one man Ghostbusters show, you brought that to Edinburgh, right?
I did. I took that to Edinburgh a few years ago and it was well received. It was Edinburgh's a real hard beast to crack. But what came out of that was I spoke to a guy who runs a Ghostbusters podcast and he's now making a documentary called Ghost Heads. And so I filmed my solo show for that documentary. And that documentary is being shown in Tribeca next month and then worldwide at some point. So
that's great.
We'll see how much of my show ends up in the documentary. Probably 2 minutes of the 2 hour show that I recorded.
2 minutes is something.
Yeah, better well, than I'll nothing. Take it. I'm going to be trading off that forever at this point.
Do you now? I know you have something in development right now. And do you feel like talking about that a little bit, or is that something you would like to?
Yeah, I'm sorry, just out of chocolate completely randomly.
I thought you said you were out.
That was a floor chocolate, Mike.
Yeah, it was. It was a floor chocolate. It actually
Brazilian chocolate.
Yeah, there is a project that I've wanted to do for a while. I've never really had the time to do it. And so I'm going to give it a go now. But basically, it's a UK version of Ghostbusters in terms of in Britain, there are a lot of sitcoms about working class people making good, like Only Fools and Horses, things like that. Mm-hmm. And so we thought, wouldn't it be great if you took a sitcom like Only Fools and Horses or Steptoe and Son, and you combined it with Ghostbusters? So it's about a bunch of really poor guys with a white van who have a lot of kit. And there was a cataclysm in the 80s, and all of a sudden everything became supernatural. And so the supernatural is literally now like a menace. So these guys are like rat catchers. And it's all very matter of fact, very British kind of kitchen sink kind of sitcom, quite dark, bit weird. But I've written 2.5 episodes. Eli says he's going to rewrite them. That was 4 weeks ago. So we're a little bit behind on the writing process.
Well, the point is, we're probably 4 weeks behind.
Yeah, so we're going to try and write 6 episodes, 15 minutes each, and crack them out in kind of seasons and things like that. So that's the plan. We're going to get there. It's called Spirit Squad.
And that's going to be an audio. That's going to be an audio series.
Yeah, it'll be an audio podcast because I really like podcasting. I really like audio. So
yeah,
that's
same here.
The plan. But like most plans, I'm like spinning plates. And so the joke I like to say is all that happens is I'm surrounded by broken crockery. So so we'll see. We'll see how it goes then.
So Anthony has a question for you.
So your show isn't going to be like Red Dwarf then? No. No, not Red Dwarf. And the funny thing is that there is a guy called Paul Gannon who is a massive Red Dwarf fan to the point of being a stalker. And I met Craig Charles from Red Dwarf once. And he goes, oh, hi, how are you? And I went, hi. And he goes, what's your name? And I went, Paul Gannon. And he froze with fear. And I wasn't quite sure why. And he goes, oh, because.
Oh, comedy errors.
I had to explain. Yeah, I had to explain I wasn't the guy who dressed up as Talkie Toaster. Right. So yeah, I'm not that guy, but no, unfortunately. And the other thing I found out about Spirit Squad is apparently it's a WWE thing as well.
Oh, Christ.
Is that true?
Oh boy,
there's a wrestling group called Spirit Squad.
Oh, they're probably like cheerleaders, like evil cheerleaders.
Yeah, maybe. So I might need to change the name, but the logo I've had since I was 14 when I first started a group up called Spirit Squad when I was a kid. So I'm going to be using that logo.
It's called the Real Spirit Squad. That's it.
So let me just say quickly, because this is something that's kind of paranormal investigations or something that's also kind of close to our hearts. Mike, do you want to talk about your paranormal investigation group?
Oh, go on.
What? The NEIA?
Yeah, the NEIA. Oh, so let me just, I'll set the stage. Mike was probably 12.
As you mentioned it.
Probably 12 when he came up
with
this.
No, we were bored. We were in a... somehow we're in sort of like a Winnebago sales lot. We're just going through Winnebagos, and I said, wouldn't it be great to have like some sort of investigation agency in one of these Winnebagos so we could just go on the road and just travel around? Wouldn't it be great if it was a paranormal one specifically?
I love that the linchpin of your fantasy
was the Winnebago.
Was the Winnebago. That's
thing,
amazing.
That everything was comfy couch. It had fold out chairs, modular tables. And I'm assuming, maybe, you know, some sort of ectoplasm storage unit, but eventually it would, if I got my funding, but, apparently,
there's Aldrich still time. Never give up on that dream.
No,
because all we didn't have a Winnebago dream. We had super soakers filled with holy water.
Sure.
And by holy water, I mean, water from a blessed church. So that was our dream.
That's brilliant.
But that
That's
was brilliant. Yeah, that was the dream. Just we do a few investigations.
We did some half-assed investigations.
My old grammar school, Laura A. Leonard School.
Yep.
We saw a red light that freaked us out. I guess it was the
eye. Yeah, and then we kind of came up with like what we actually saw, which was probably not actual reality. Yeah,
the shortest and longest game of
time. What I will say, actually, is if the timing works out and I can sort something out and you have the time, let's try and do a ghost hunt when you come over then.
Oh, my gosh. Sure. I think our ladies would love that as well. So, yeah, we'll do that.
Let me have a look into that then.
Yeah.
There are a few paranormal groups and paranormal tourism kind of things where you can pay a few, like, 20, 30.
Oh, that'd be amazing. We should do that.
Yeah. Can I be the antagonizing guy, like the guy from Ghost Adventures? Like, come at me, bro. Come at me, ghost bro.
Zach. Is that his name?
I think so. It's got to be.
He's the guy who went into a house where a woman chopped up her family, took the murder weapon from a museum in with it, bounced it on the corner of a table, and threatened the ghost to push the axe into his face. That's how hardcore he is.
Jeez. Well, I admire
the dedication,
but he's still fired in my mind.
But yeah, we'll try and work that out. If the heavens,
that would be a lot of fun. We can record it.
Yeah,
spooky.
We can definitely do that.
Yeah, Kevin mentions Escape to Witch Mountain.
Oh
which,
yeah, that was definitely
which is certainly one of our favorite films.
But also with the Winnebago
of all time.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That makes perfect sense.
Yeah, The Rock is excellent in that film. That's the one you're getting.
Oh, yeah. You're referring to...
No?
The Rock. You know, actually, every film. However, my son told me that he had a half day, like a day that where they stopped doing schoolwork for some reason halfway through. I think it was a snow day, and he and another kid were there. And he told me that they watched Escape to Witch Mountain. And... he said he really liked it, and I didn't have the heart to ask him which version that he'd seen, because I wanted to keep in my mind that he was talking about the version from the past.
This is our dilemma as the age that we're at. Our generation.
Usually I get to him early, though. Usually I get to him early.
Versus.
You need to indoctrinate them.
He's seen a lot of old stuff and enjoys it. So there was an Onion article that resonated with me, which was, I'll see if I can find it. But the essential thing was that this father had gotten his daughter into all of this old music, ensuring that she would never have a social life.
Right.
You know, because all the stuff that she liked was, you know, 30 years.
Yeah.
But
that's how the kids rebel now. They insist on liking the remakes and the reboots better than the original.
Right.
See, I've got to try to fine line with that because I've currently been defending the Ghostbusters reboot to death.
Oh, yeah.
I can't be snobby about it.
Yeah. I've seen that. That's the backlash about that is just embarrassing on a humanity level. It's completely unnecessary. It seems like arbitrary and knee jerk reaction as well.
I actually got a tweet. I got a message, direct message from Paul.
Yeah, Feig, that's awesome.
You were defending. You were a staunch defender.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, my logic is just I'll wait till I see the film before I form an opinion. That's the bottom basic line.
Decent logic.
I get why there's all this outrage. Yeah. But I wrote this article and he sent me a direct message and it was really, what's the word I'm looking for? Candid. He was really honest about why he did it.
That's great.
I saw that. That was great.
Yeah, so it was sweet and that he reached out as well. So I feel sorry for him at the moment because no one deserves that. Not the cast don't deserve that kind of stuff, you know. So
I think we talked about this a little bit online. I'm pretty sure when it comes out, it's going to be fantastic and people are just going to shut up. And unfortunately, they may forget about
it. My joke right now is it only has to get better reviews than Superman versus Batman. And that's currently at 26% on Rotten Tomatoes. Yeah. So even if it gets 29, I still
you still win. Yes.
Yeah.
Anthony's asking us about our opinion about the Haunted Mansion with Eddie Murphy. I will say right off the bat, I have not seen it. I have no interest in seeing it, but, that is, purely because that ride is absolutely perfect.
It doesn't need to be anything else but a ride.
The ride's beautiful.
Yeah, it's amazing.
The ride it's a work of art. It's an absolute work of art. And,
like the Watchmen doesn't need to be anything else besides a graphic novel.
I thought the film looked beautiful.
Looked beautiful as a moving emulation of the page.
Yeah, it's got no plot. It's completely inert in terms of there's no excitement.
It meanders from one set to another. Yeah, it's just
and there's nothing to it, and that's the saddest thing. There's no excitement. There's no adventure. Just Eddie Murphy gurning and yet playing the straight man in a film he stars in.
Yeah, and Haunted Mansion, that was Zack Snyder as well, right?
Zack Snyder.
No, that was the guy who directed the lighting. I was gonna say, don't test me on these things. You know, Del Toro is aiming to make his own remake.
That would just blow my mind. I would love that.
That's the dream, because he has a secret room in his house. When you open a little thing, it's a whole room built to look like the Haunted Mansion. So, yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Makes me extremely jealous.
Although, if you are desperate, Steve Guttenberg in the 90s did make a film based on the ride, Tower of Terror, the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror.
Oh, yeah. Is that any good?
Actually, it's better than the Eddie Murphy Haunted Mansion film. Although that bar isn't particularly high to clear.
Yeah.
So there you go.
What other?
So have I rambled on too much? Like, shall I give you back your?
Well, I think we're probably going to wrap things up fairly soon anyway. So, it has been lovely to talk to you, sir.
No, it's always a pleasure. I love you guys, and I love the podcast, and I'm glad everything is going excellently for you. It's well deserved.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man. And we look forward to seeing more of Spirit Squad in
whatever, or any of it, whatever shape. Point
well, we
it's only been 4 weeks.
Right, right. No, it'll be great. And anything we can do to help, please let us know.
Mm. All right, cheers, guys. Well, I'll leave you to it then to tie up, and I will sign off. Right.
See you, Paul.
Take care, guys.
Take care.
He's still Paul's there. Oh no, okay. Paul's a great guy. And everyone should definitely, if you've listened to all of the Hadron episodes and you want a little bit of more Hadron, go check out our appearances on the Cheap Show Halloween specials. The most recent one in particular is extremely funny because there is a haunted house involved, and Paul and Eli are fantastic in it. So
yeah, they're really funny. That whole episode is really funny.
But their show is great in general. So check out Cheap Show. And we always love having Paul on our show. And I think the new episode will be fun. And we will actually I think at this point in the evening, since we still have some folks watching and, folks have kind of hung in with us over an hour, we can talk a little bit about some maybe non-spoilery stuff about next season. You want to try to venture into that area?
Yeah, we could do that.
All right. We're going to try to do it without spoiling anything, though, right?
Right.
Maybe we shouldn't. Let's not.
Possible?
No, let's not. There's no. I was going to say.
Some hijinks.
I can guarantee everybody. I can guarantee.
Cracks.
Right. Paul will be back on the show next season.
Yes.
As will Eli. And it's actually going to be.
We're trying to get a lot of old friends back.
There's going to be a lot of old friends, a lot of new friends. There's going to be a lot more
product.
Product. There's going to be a lot more exploration of the multiverse. It's probably not a spoiler to say that.
A lot more exploration. Yeah, that's fair to say. Sure. Taking it on the road, maybe. Who knows?
Yeah. Well, I think we should probably wrap it up then. Do you have any final thoughts for folks as we get ready to wrap it up for the evening?
Thank you so much for sticking around. You guys are the best. You really do, just for showing up and listening and the feedback, you really do, again, it makes it all totally worthwhile. And but keep the noise going. Just tell a friend, tell another friend, check us out on social media. Reviews are great. We'll just keep churning them out.
Yeah. I want to mention one last time, the Patreon site, the Patreon page. One of the things that we're doing to thank people for just going there to look is we've got a PDF up there of the very first Hadron Gospel Hour script. So you can download that and read along with the first episode if you like. And we're going to put a couple more up there. Just for people in general, I think once people Once you become a patron, again, even at the $1 amount, you'll have access to all of our PDFs of every episode, which, you know, that may be a blessing to some, curse to others.
You can scratch the names off and put your name there if you want to print it out. That's fun. People do that sometimes. Don't do that. But you can if you want.
I really do. I think, yeah, we're just super grateful for everybody who listens, and we'll have a new episode for you in probably a week or so. And we're super excited about it. It's probably going to be a little bit of a king sized episode, as will the last episode of the season. These last two episodes are going to be like packed with information. That's a terrible way. This next audio drama is going to be so much packed with information. No, the next show is going to be packed with some action, with a lot of new changes and
fan favorite Commander Funk.
Fan favorite Commander Funk will be hanging out with us. So please check that out. Our social media, again, we're on Twitter. Obviously, most of you, I guess, who are already in this chat know that, at Hadron Gospel. On Facebook, it's facebook.com/HGH show. Newsletter is tinyletter.com/HadronGospel. I think Mike, your Twitter handle is at Professor Static with a K. Mine
I don't know why I stuck with that one, but I just keep it.
I like it. I think it's a good one. Mine is at Rich Wentworth. And so, you know, follow us, you know, subscribe to this channel, because we'll be coming back from time to time, probably, like I said, every couple to few weeks, to give you guys updates on what's happening. And again, we'll also be giving frequent updates in the Patreon channel as well. So we're super excited about this next phase of HGH, and, you know, invite you all to come along for the ride. We're so happy that you've been with us so far. And yeah, we love you. So we'll see you soon.
I hear you, Chris. I'm not into the Blab. I like the Blab thing, but I'm not into the Twitter thing.
And by the way, there's a couple of folks who have been in this chat who signed up with Twitter, and Icarus is one of them. Who signed up for Twitter specifically to do this, and we totally appreciate that. I know that, you know, it's probably not a platform you're excited about, but we're excited to have you here, and really happy that you did it. So thank you so much for doing that. That means a lot.
We'll be back.
Come back. And yeah, again, this conversation, keep it going. We'll talk more on the Facebook and Twitter, wherever you guys are comfortable. We're on Tumblr as well. Hadron Gospel Hour, search us on Tumblr. We're a little bit older, so it's hard for us to understand that platform, but we're doing our best. and we've got a lot of great fans there.
So many pictures of stuff. You want to try to do a freeze frame high five on the camera?
Where are you?
I'm over the other way. All right, let's do that.
It depends on where we are in
where your mic, like where your mic is.
Hold on.
There you go. Yeah. High five.
But do one over here too, because
do one over here too.
That's okay.
No, it's very Vogue.
Someone get a screenshot. Get a screenshot. All right, guys. Thanks so much for coming.
That was
good night.
Thanks, guys. Clicking off.
Oh, there it is. Oh, good.